Today, I'm sharing the easiest way to create seamless repeat patterns using Procreate, and I'm providing everything you need to do it for free. Pick up the free pattern template brush, color palette, and pattern types cheat sheet right in the video description. Let's get started. You'll want to have a square canvas for this since all of our templates were created at a square format, and that part's really important. It doesn't really matter the size that you choose to use, the larger the better. I'm using 3600 pixels by 3600 pixels at 300 dpi. I work in the Display P3 color profile, but if you don't have access to that, then the default sRGB color profile is perfectly fine. The first thing I'm going to do is head into the pattern templates brush set. And I'm going to select abstract number 2, and I'm going to provide this for free. If you'd like to follow along, just tap in the link in the video description. I've also included a couple other freebies in there for you as well. You can choose any color for this. I generally like choosing like a gray, so I just double tap where the gray is, and that gives me like a medium gray. And then just tap it in with your finger or your stylus. And then you want to select it. And then down here, just choose fit to canvas, and that will fill out your entire canvas with your template. Next, I'm going to switch to my darkest blue color, and I'll provide this color palette for free in the video description as well if you'd like to follow along exactly. And for this, I'm just going to be using a default brush, and it's found in the calligraphy category. So this comes with Procreate, and it's called the monoline brush. So I've got that selected. In my layers palette, I'm going to create a brand new layer right above my template layer. And you can draw whatever you'd like in here, and you don't have to have insane illustration skills. We're just going to make sure that we're following the template contours, and you don't need to go straight up to the edge of anything. You just follow it around and just don't go outside of the white area. That's the main rule here. And you'll get a different outcome with any template that you use. So even if you're using the exact same elements for every pattern you make, if you're following a different template, you're going to get something unique every single time. All right, when you have it the way you'd like, I'm just going to fill this in, choose continue filling, and then just tap in each of these. I'm going to create a brand new layer and just fill in the center with my yellowish orange color. All right, we've got our first flower complete, and I'm going to fill in the rest of these ovals with similar daisies. So I'm just following the contour once again and my template. I'll fill these ones in just like before. And then I'm going to return back to my blue petal layer, select the same blue color, and I'll add a stamen to all of my yellow flowers. I'd actually like the stamen to be on top of the petals, seeing how it looks right here. So I'm just going to drag that layer above my yellow layer and then fill in those stamens. So very simple design, but it's pretty cool how it all comes together in the end. So we've got our design filled in. I am going to add in a background color. So I'm going to come right above my template, create a brand new layer, and I'm going to drop in this kind of maroon color. And we could just stop right here because we filled in our template and we can actually preview our pattern. We've got a pattern already. So I'm going to show you what that looks like. And then I'm going to show you how you can expand this even further if you'd like a more dynamic or just more detailed pattern. So with it like this, we've already covered up our template layer, so you can't see it because we've got our background color on. I'm going to come to the topmost layer. I'm going to use a 3-finger swipe and choose copy all, and then swipe again and choose paste. And now we've got our pattern square. And what I'm going to do is just toggle this up, open up Safari, and drag it to the left. And I've got Pattern Playground loaded up. And Pattern Playground is our free pattern preview tool. You can preview full drop, half drop, and half brick patterns. You can rescale them. You can even save out repeats. My husband coded this up for anyone to use. It's completely free, and you can find it at patternplayground.com. So what I'm going to do is in Procreate, I'm just going to grab that pattern square that we just pasted, drag it over, and just drop it in. And that's all you have to do. We're technically creating full drop, but if you don't expand this any further or add in any extra details, you can preview this as a half drop, a half brick, and a full drop. So full drop will look like this. I'm going to reduce the size of it so you can see how that's repeating, which is really pretty. It kind of reminds me of a tablecloth, actually. And if we want it to be a little more dynamic, all we have to do is tap on half drop. So that's a preview of half drop. And then here's half brick. And in the video description, if you pick up the free pattern template brush, I'll also include my pattern types cheat sheet in there. So it's got a bunch of examples and explains how each one of these different pattern types works. It's super helpful to have on hand whenever you're creating a brand new pattern. So I'm going to return back to full drop, but we can do better than this. So I'm going to show you how you can expand this pattern and add more details to it. We've got the base of our pattern right now. And what we want to do is I just like grouping my individual layers. That way I have access to them if I ever need them. I am excluding the pasted in pattern square that we have up at the top. And I will group these ones together. And they're just in the reserves. They're just there if we ever need them in the future. I'm going to turn off their visibility. And now with this pattern square, I'm going to duplicate this. So I've got four copies and I'm going to turn the visibility of all of the other copies off. So I only have the top one with the visibility checked. Next, I'm going to hit the wrench icon, come over to Canvas, toggle on drawing guide, and then hit edit drawing guide. Down here under 2D grid, we're going to toggle this grid size all the way to max. And we can't see it right now because we've got a dark background in here. So I'm going to tap on this rainbow slider and make it a much lighter color. And it's still kind of hard to see. So I'm going to increase the thickness and the opacity on this. And now we can see a lot better. I'm going to hit done. And next, I'm going to grab this topmost pattern square, select it. Down here in your selection palette, you're going to tap on snapping and toggle on magnetics and snapping and make sure distance and velocity are toggled up to max. Now this will snap in place as we move it to our four corners. So I'm going to drag this and it'll just snap. There we go. Now I'm going to turn on the next one, select it, and then drag this up to the next corner until it snaps. Next one, and then the last one. And now we can see where our white space is. And if you want to fill this and make it a more ornate pattern, now you've got it all perfectly lined up for you to add more details in. So we're just going to add in a few more details, and then I'll show you how you can preview it and then save that repeat. So I'm going to come up to the topmost layer, create a brand new layer, and I'm going to switch to my lighter blue color. I still have my monoline brush selected, and I'm just going to do kind of like a doodle around the outside. This is a very simple design, kind of with that doodle feel, so I'm not worrying about being too precise here. I'm going to create a brand new layer. I'm going to select my yellow color, and we're just going to put one more daisy on the inside here. I'll give myself petals on the four corners now that I've got that guideline. And I'm going to repeat this teardrop shape in these corners. We'll fill all of those in. And then just create a brand new layer and add a stamen with the dark blue to this middle flower, just for consistency with the other ones. Okay, I'm going to repeat the exact same steps that we followed before. I'm going to three-finger swipe and choose copy all. Make sure I'm on the topmost layer. Three-finger swipe again and choose paste. And now I have this pattern square up at the top, and we can drop it back into the pattern playground to preview our final pattern. So toggle this up, drag Safari to the left, drag that pattern square in. And remember that once you fill this out, if you decide to add more details, it's going to have to be a full drop because this method works for full drop patterns. So just make sure down here, if it's not looking right, you just want to tap full drop and then everything will look correct. I'm going to toggle this down so we can see more of it at a time. And I'm really happy with how this came. It actually looks like floor tiles now. I'm pretty happy with how that came out, even though it was a quick doodle. So the other things that you can do while you're here, you can recolor or play around with some other color versions if you'd like. All you have to do is tap on this blend mode. You can just slide colors around and then choose different blend modes and kind of get a preview. So it's a nice way to kind of play around with your pattern and see if there's another color version that you would like in here. I like my default, so I'm just going to hit reset right here and then hit save image, download. And then right here, this is your little download icon in your browser. So tap on that. Then your pattern will appear right up at the top. You can just tap there. And here is your pattern as a repeat. If you'd like to put it on mockups and kind of see how it looks everywhere, I can save this also to my camera roll by hitting the export icon and then just choosing save image. And now it's saved to my camera roll. But remember that this is a web JPEG, so it's not high resolution. This isn't something that you would want to sell and deliver directly to a client. It's just for mock-up purposes or preview purposes only. If you're ready to use your pattern as it is on something larger, what you'll want to do is create your brand new canvas at the size that you'll need it at. For this example, I just created a screen size canvas, so you can see it's not a square anymore. I'll come back here where my pattern is, and here is my pattern square. I'm just going to tap on it and choose copy. Head back into my screen size canvas. I can three-finger swipe and choose paste, and this will paste my pattern square in. Now I can resize it however I would like. And if you still have your snapping and your magnetics turned on, it'll make everything super easy here. So I'm just going to slide it over, and then I can duplicate this, and this will perfectly tile in here. So then I could even merge these two together, duplicate them, and then slide this down. And there we go. Once you have your pattern square the way you like it, it's really easy to tile and put in any other canvas size that you need it to be. And whenever you're tiling it within Procreate on that larger canvas, you're then creating a high resolution repeat for a client or for your own use. So it's just something to keep in mind. And if you'd like more inspiration on how you can use these, if you pick up the full set of these pattern template brushes, I've also included an inspiration guide as a PDF that comes with the download that shows all 30 template brushes as different patterns. So you can take inspiration from them. You can pull the color palettes directly if you'd like. But if you're feeling stuck and you just need some ideas, then that's a great guide to lean on. If you enjoyed this tutorial, please hit the like button, subscribe, and I will see you next time.